our class. Today, once again, I am here to talk with you about a new lesson. So, students, as you know that we started a new unit. So, students, today we have to learn a beautiful moral story, which is very important us for to shape our future. Means, while learning this story or lesson, we will learn moral. We will get some moral values through this story. So, name of this lesson is Weeds in the Garden. Weeds. Weeds means what? You can see into the picture. The small, small, unnecessary or undesired plants are known as weeds. So, students, it is telling us about our own life. As you know that we all are human beings. So, being a human, obviously there are some good habits and bad habits among us. Each and every person have some good habits and some bad habits. But if the bad habits are going to influence on good habits, so it is not good for our life or our personality. So we have to mitigate the bad habits at proper time. We do not have to let them grow. If we do so we have to face many type of consequences in our life. Right? So this story is also giving us an important message about the habits. So students, as you know that most of the parents like to fulfill the wishes of their children. You can take your own example. Whatever wish you are expressing in front of your parents are trying to fulfill them. Right? Because they want that my child should get each and everything and he should be happy. Right? It is the wish of every parent. But sometimes when we are behaving opposite of our parents' wish or we are not doing what they are expecting from us, at that time our parents are getting angry. Sometimes they are scolding us. Right? So, but behind this anger or behind this scolding, they do not have any their own benefit. They want our good, means they want our good development. They want to shape our good characters. That's why they are trying to force us towards the good habits. So through this lesson, we will also learn about a same boy whose name was Anshuman. So students, I want to tell you that you are also students, means children. Some students have good habits, some students have bad habits. But each and every student have some good or bad habits. For example, you are not doing study properly, you are not completing homework regularly, you are not maintaining your personal hygiene, right? So these habits gradually goes to be stronger, and if they fix their root, so it is very difficult for us to uproot them. So at the proper time we have to stop this. Therefore they cannot develop. Here I want to show you one example. So see students, in my hand it is wet clay. Now this clay is wet. So whatever shape I want to give it, I can give. Now it is easy for me to give my desired shape to this clay. The reason behind it that it is wet. So it is easy for me. But now this is dry. So I cannot give my desired shape to this. How much I tried, but I cannot give. Why? Because now it is beyond my limits and it is the dry. So if I try to give it my desired shape, so what will happen? See, it will break like this. It will break like this. Both examples you saw. So through these examples, what I want to tell? I want to tell that when the habits are growing, at that time we have to stop them. We do not have to let them develop. Otherwise, it will be difficult for us to end that bad habits. Okay. Another example I want to show you that how to end the bad habits at right time. So you can see here, this is the small plant. I hope you are seeing this. So see this plant. Now it is very small. So that's why I can easily uproot it. See. Right? But at the same time, you can see that this is a big tree. And how much I try, so I cannot uproot this tree because it fixes his roots under the ground. So it is hard to take out. So we can get the message from this example that bad habits we have to end before developing them. So if we let them develop, so they will become hard for us to end. I hope you understand this example. So students, now we have to see our lesson. So in this lesson, there is a one boy who is the main character. Name of that boy is Anshuman. Anshuman's parents noticed that he had developing some bad habits, and his parents tried to stop this. Time to time they are telling him, they are suggesting him, sometimes they are scolding him. When Anshuman's parents noticed that their son Anshuman had developing some bad habits, so they began to warn him. Means time to time they are giving warning to him to stop this. Sometimes they are scolding him, sometimes they are punishing him. But all efforts are not useful. They tried everything short of beating him up. Sometimes they were beating him. But last they were unhappy that because their efforts are not coming to fruit. Means their efforts were not more useful. So, as I told you that Anshuman's parents were worried about Anshuman's bad habits and they were trying to stop this. They were using different type of efforts, but they were not useful. So once upon, Anshuman and his father went to his grandfather's farm and Anshuman's father took him for walk. While walking, Anshuman's father were telling him about the specialities of the various plants which were present in that farm. While walking, suddenly they stopped at small seedling or plant. And Anshuman's father told to Anshuman, take out that plant. So it was very small, so easily Anshuman take out that. After that, again they start to walk. By going some distance, again they stop. And once again Anshuman's father told to him, Anshuman, this plant is also not useful for our farm, you take out this. So by doing little more efforts than the previous, Anshuman take out that second plant also. After this, again they continue their walk. Now they came to the end of their farm and there was some different type of plants grown. So again Anshuman's father told that, Anshuman, these plants are also not useful for us. We have to take out them, otherwise they will be harmful for our crops in the farm. So once again Anshuman's father told to Anshuman to take out that plant. And that plant was bigger in size as compared to previous plants. And Anshuman tried again and again, again and again tried. But he had to do more efforts as compared to previous. And finally, by doing the efforts with might and main, doing all power. So Anshuman tried more and more to take out that plant, but he was unsuccessful. And what he told, "I can't get this out," exclaimed Anshuman. Means now Anshuman said that, "I can't do this. It is quite hard for me and it has gone too deep into the soil." So after getting these words from the Anshuman, Anshuman's brothers brought some tools and implements to take out that plant. Now with the help of that tools, Anshuman take out that plant, but then also he had to do more efforts. And at last he take out that big plant also. After that, when Anshuman take out that plant with the help of that implements which brought by his father, so while returning at home, Anshuman's father told to Anshuman that habits are also like these weeds. If we take out them at right time, so they cannot develop. If we allow them to develop, it goes to be hard to stop them. So by listening from his father these words, Anshuman realized the truth. He understood that what his father want to say. And from this incident, Anshuman took a right lesson and he stopped his habits. So students, in this way we learn our lesson. So now we have to see the hard words. Students, by learning this lesson, we got the message that we have to stop our bad habits before developing. If once they develop, so it is very hard for us to end these habits. So students, I hope you understand this lesson. Okay? Thank you.